sung in decades.
I'm nervous, me too.
Three.
Four.
Repent.
Paddock. I'm rolling over my grave right now.
I'm not going through this. I'm leaving.
Get back here. We've been given the chance of a lifetime, and we only get one wish.
And we only have 2 hours to complete our mission. We'll lose the power of three-dimensional ectoplasmic manifestations.
Right.
Come on, come on. We can make the biggest comeback since Lazarus.
Hey guys, look, our old stop is here.
Wow.
How did it get here?
The Lord works in mysterious ways.
The Lord is our stage manager. We shot that one.
Let's see and get it over with. We're not warmed up.
Poor talented.
So much to do. Take the dust covers off the microphones.
Over the writing words.
The words, the notes,
the moves. I knew the tones.
Oh no, he's hyperventilating again. He's hyperventilating.
Whoa.
I'll be okay. You just go over your lyrics.
We can't afford any screw ups.
I'm just here to help out Otto. Mr. Bodie.
And now, let's meet our class.
Good evening. We're the staff of class, and we're dead. And, we never got to do the show when we were, you know, alive. And now that we're not, we're hoping to do the show that we could have done when we should have, if we could have, which we couldn't, so we didn't. But now, through the miracle of modern miracles, we can.
You see, it's because of all this astrotechnical stuff, like the stars being in conjunction with the positions of the planets, and the sounds of our voices combined with the expanding holes in the ozone layer, make it possible for us to do the show that we didn't, but we couldn't, and now we can.
Anyway, we're here, you're there, and I'm Sparky.
I'm Smudge.
Oh, jinx!
He was my stepbrother.
Frankie.
His real name is Francis.
And now, the rest of the class.
Hi there, I'm Rhoda.
Hello, I'm Louise.
I'm Lilith.
Oh, God bless. Mary Agnes. It's short for Mary Agnes.
I'm Betty. Tony.
Yo.
I'm Connie.
Adele. My first name is actually Della, but I go, or went by, my middle name Adele.
Ira.
I'm Corinne.
My twin sister. Well, you don't look like her.
I'm older.
Lionel.
Woo!
Dolores, but call me Doc.
Hi, my name's Gladys, but you don't have to call me anything.
I'm real though. Like in this Rita Hayworth movie, where she's a woman with the pads and a really tight gown.
I love really tight gowns!
Anyway, she's under the control of this mad Korean guy who has something to do with the nuclear stuff and nightclubs. Anyways, in comes Harrison Ford.
No, not Harrison Ford, Richie.
She said she's Clara, and she doesn't speak. Or she said, where is the library? One of the two.
She gave us our dance steps.
I'm Mitzi.
She was our foreign exchange student.
From Glockenstockenstan.
We've never heard of it either, but my stepfather,
my real father,
was stationed there during the war.
I'm really confused.
And now, the musicians.
That's Uncle Luke on the bass. He's not really my uncle. Mom just had him around since Dad went to Korea. He was driving the bus.
And on piano, we have... Mrs. Eunice Wiggins!
We don't really know her. She came with the Catholic Gymnatorium. But anyway, we've waited an entire lifetime to be able to stand before you tonight and ask the musical question.
Ooh, which one will the fountain bless? Which one will the fountain bless? Three coins in the fountain. Through the ripples, how they shine.
Just one wish will be granted.
Make it mine,
sweating elsewhere.
Hey, you guys, we never sounded this good in life.
It's all starting to come back to me now.
Me too.
Me too. Once you learn how to hold it, you never let go of your part.
Let's keep it moving. Remember what happens if we don't.
Tonight, we would like to thank you for allowing us the opportunity to do the show we never got to do in life.
You see, we had been saving up for this real boss button series.
Similar to groovy
and plaid concert dresses.
So, for full effect, if you squint and think plaid, we could all look like this.
You guys have plaid glasses? No? You guys don't have them? What a shame.
This next song is dedicated to all of you eighth graders out there,
and to anybody who's ever been to a student council dance.
We love student council. We'll echo through the years.
Me dry.
Me fear.
Me move.
Let's hurry this along.
Ooh, it's time for Crazy Belcher. It's time for Crazy Belcher.
I love this song. I just love it.
Me too. The choreography is too treacherous.
Couldn't they just use the...
I don't know. Ask them.
Ladies and gentlemen, there was this number I heard the kids practicing in the janitor's supply closet, which was surprisingly empty, except for a few useful hand trucks unused, especially when student council needed them. They worked so hard on it and were hoping to add to their repertoire, but since they never had the opportunity to perform it with real microphones, they would feel more comfortable if they could premiere it the way they rehearsed.
Using these plumber's helpers as microphones.
Is that all right with you?
On? So listen closely.
Ooh,
left when I had the chance.
I need my hookup back, Nisha.
Me too.
I'll be fine. Just give me a second.
Take it easy on the eighth flats.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to have to excuse Jinx. He has a contusiated cartilage.
We'll get back to the show in a moment with...
Perfidia.
Perfidia, yes. Meanwhile...
Ladies and gentlemen, don't panic. There seems to be a temporary power outage. I will go look for the emergency generator and...
Me and Dolores will go find the flashlights. Let's go, Auntie Pips.
Scott, Corinne, cover for us. Keep the show going.
And?
You're not really good at pattern.
Please, we can't stop the show. Time's moving on.
What are we saying?
You just have to talk to the audience. They're just people like you or me.
They're alive. While chaos ensues,
we'll forge ahead.
You know that old saying, you can't take it with you? You can. You're allowed one suitcase.
So, we took our props and bass charts and snuck in our record book.
You see, our parents had bought this diner from this insurance money they got from this accident.
They had to give the sitter Wednesdays off for beauty school. So we'd hang around the diner, wait for the jukebox lady to come, and take out all the old records no one was playing anymore. She'd give them to us.
That's where we got the idea to sing Perfidia.
We'd sit there for hours, just looking at them, staring at their labels.
Reading them over and over.
Memorizing the composer's names.
The time of each song.
Watching them drop down from the record changer.
Watching the little style song. Move on to the next record with impeccable precision, like a little soldier.
And of course we'd be in a rapturized state just listening to them.
Sometimes we'd mouth the words. Hey, nonny, ding dong, line, line, line.
We'd make sock puppets and pretend they were the McGuire sisters.
The Ames brothers.
The Cordettes.
The Four Aces.
The Four Lads.
The high low.
Boys to men? Never mind. Thinking ahead.
Then we graduated to LPs!
What a feeling.
Hitting a new record.
Slipping your finger in the thumbnail jacket.
Don't get a paper cut!
Breaking the cellophane.
We, all of us, always dreamed of making an album of our very own.
We even made these neat record covers ourselves. The sound of plaid sings the sound of music.
Forever plaid.
In a plaid mood.
Classical plaid.
The good, the plaid, and the ugly.
The plaid. Solid gold hits.
The plaid swing songs of inspiration.
And the Christmas album,
Glad Tidings. Although we never got to make an album to sell ourselves,
we would always sell the record covers, keep dreaming of the day we could stuff them.
It was a good dream.
As Jinx coagulated?
Is the weeping in the ritual fences?
I think so.
Okay, people, all reset. Yeah, come on.
That would make the sound emanate from deeper within his bowels. Maybe that was under pressure.
Never had much experience with tortured romance. So to give our music focus, we would concentrate on our Spanish teacher.
Oh, Senorita Casales.
She was the third runner-up at the Soviet
contest. We girls think of our drama teacher, Mr. Tomato.
Still hot.
We didn't know their real first names, so we pretended they were named Ophidia, because we all had to sing this song called Ophidia.
And he'll take the song for personal meaning.
We each had personal experience with one or the other.
Yeah. Let's go. One, two, three, wait.
I don't remember any of the moves.
You just bounce a lot. You do this and this.
Don't worry, you won't screw up. Just follow us and remember.
We're the proud, the pure.
Oh, thank goodness.
And the black.
Thank you. Wearing a frown. You hear a Parties. Down, up, Bethlehem, how still we Peterson. Get it?
Got it.
Very good now.
Let's go!
to take you up from paradise up above. If you were to tell me I'd be the only one that you love, then life would be a dream, sweetheart.
Hello, hello again, it's a room that's over again.
Life would be a dream, if only all my wishes would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you,
where was I?
Anyway, the
two senior TV crews were on their way to Candystown to do a TV special in Perry's hometown. We kept our composure long enough to take a look at the car, but right before I was going to dig into that big old engine, I realized I didn't know what I was doing. I looked over at Betty, but she was drooling over Mr. C. I signaled her and got her attention to help me out with the motor.
As I walked to the front of the car, I realized this could be a moment of destiny, of fate, of kismet. In other words, a magic moment. All of us, the sound of clap, were serenading the opening of the new combo, ice rink and driving laundromat, skating wake. So I pushed Tony out of the way and I ripped out the cab's carburetor. I told the chauffeur it would take 6 hours to get another one.
Mr. Como and Miss Clooney shrugged and took in a stride. I suggested that Missy and Mr. C and the chauffeur come to the rinks and partake in our shumptuous buffet. You know, have a skate, do their laundry, and catch our show. Later that night, there they were. Perry Como, Rosemary Clooney, and the chauffeur ringside folding their whites and watching us sing.
The show was going great. Then, right after the Mambo combo, Miss Tyler appealed.
Me too.
We could continue the charade no longer. We're stopping now. Mr. C.
Miss C.
We said, here's your carburetor. We're sorry for having to deceive you, but before you call the police, we just want you to know we did it because we've gotten so much out of listening to you all our lives. We just wanted to say thank you, the only way we knew how.
Without reason, we handed them the carburetor. With slight redness in the eye, they handed us their matching golden cardigans.
Yeah.
Thank you. spending your night with us as a special prize by presenting you with this PLAID covered dental floss. But please remember that fluoridation is no substitute for good oral hygiene. Just ask any dentist.
And please take it back to your seat and pass it through the audience.
If all of you sign it, so you can put it in a good word for you, and keep happy, you know, after you leave.
One last round of applause for Mrs. Adderholm. Mercomatic Drive!
Beautiful. Oh,
unified family and home.
I speak your name. from rags to riches. My fate is up to you.
You sail over melodies, creating new galaxies as you go.
You propel yourself to
the Dakota as you parachute down the snow-covered port, cushioning down on the cloud of warm sound.
You hold on to that last note. You don't want to say goodbye to the song.
You keep on singing, longer and stronger. And then as one, you cut off. There is only silence, quality silence. Sleek sweat drips down our collective necks. It's a good sweat. One perfect chord, one perfect moment. And that's all anybody has the right to ask for. And we had more than our share. Rehearsing at the warehouse was our Madison Square Garden. Singing in the cracked seat cushions of our Dodge school bus was our Carnegie Hall. And opening at the VA hospital was our Ed Sullivan Show. And it was good, damn it! Excuse me, but it was good. Really good. And it still is.
Mr. Bunny's right.
Otto.